ASUS ZenBook UX305 Car Review. Design. This is a lovely looking machine. Fully clad in anodized aluminium and with a maximum thickness of just 12.3 millimeters, the UX305 Ka is a slim and light picture of premium perfection. Screen quality. One of the great strengths of the original ZenBook UX305 was its superb quality screen, and on first impression the UX305 Ka appears to benefit equally. The matte finish IPS panel has offers good viewing angles and keeps reflections to a minimum. It's also bright and displays punchy looking colors, while still appearing to be able to create a reasonable black level. Performance. The addition of Intel's new Skylake-based Core M processor to this machine has made quite a difference to its performance. While it still trails most other Ultrabooks, I recorded a noticeable 36% jump in the Cinebench R15 benchmark compared to last year's model, 155 to 212 points. This was also reflected in Geekbench 3, where the score jumped from 4,098 to 4,817, a 17.5% increase. In PC Mark 7 the gains were lower, only 3%, but it still adds up to a decent speed bump. What's more, this was noticeable in day-to-day use. While the old model was noticeably sluggish, and less able to cope with multiple tasks than your average Ultrabook, the ZenBook UX305 Ka feels more snappy overall. For those interested in gaming, the news is even better. In the Unigen Heaven benchmark performance leapt from 9.4 FPS to 13.4 FPS. While this is way below playable, it suggests that you're more likely to get a playable experience without having to resort to dropping the resolution and detail settings of games to ridiculous levels. Battery life. Sadly, that leap in performance wasn't joined by a leap in battery life. In fact, the UX305 Ka managed only 7 hours, 35 minutes. In contrast, the model I reviewed last year lasted for 11 hours, 50 minutes. Much of that is likely down to the difference in the screen resolution, so I suspect that the 1080p version of the UX305 Ka will perform far better. Until I test it, though, I can't say for certain, and of course it isn't an official UK model anyway.